Every winter, most parts of the UK battle with gale force winds. According to the Met Office report, gusts of at least 90 miles per hour are recorded. In this video, we will demonstrate how SOLIDWORKS Flow Simulation data can be transferred into SOLIDWORKS Simulation. The model we're going to use is a traffic light. This multi-body part will experience hurricane force winds at 40 meters per second, which is approximately 90 miles per hour. Using flow simulation, we are going to find the force caused by the incoming wind, thereafter transfer flow results to SOLIDWORKS Simulation for finite element analysis. To simulate a realistic scenario, I've modelled the traffic light with acceptable materials applied. The signalling pole structure is assigned with galvanised steel to ensure corrosion resistance and strength with outside conditions. The street nameplate is assigned with 5052 aluminium alloy. This alloy is highly resistant to corrosion and has high tensile strength, making it ideal for outdoor signage applications. The traffic light's housing body is assigned with ABS polycarbonate. With any simulation study, it is essential to simplify the model down by suppressing geometry which is deemed insignificant for analysis, such as rounds and logos. This process will increase the solution time and avoid any meshing issues. I've made a new configuration ready for simulation. In this configuration, I have removed the bulbs and the split line feature, which was used to create the street name. To start my flow simulation, the project wizard will provide the most convenient way to set up the flow simulation conditions and specify the configuration used. I'm going to name the project name as Traffic Light. I'm going to leave the configuration as simplified. I'm also going to leave the unit system as per the default values. In the analysis type, I will ensure that it is set to be external. For the default fluid, choose air. For the wall conditions, leave it with the default settings as well. For the initial and ambient conditions, I will specify the wind values in the Z direction. The positive and negative sign will indicate the direction of the wind, which is highlighted by the blue arrow. The next step will be to modify the computational domain for a suitable external analysis. Then we'll want to create some goals. I'm going to create a surface goal to understand the flow effects on the traffic light housing body, which are going to be used for convergence. Then run the study with the default mesh refinement values. Once the simulation has finished solving, we can now create a cut plot to visualize the velocity at the traffic light using the contours and vectors. Thereafter, you may also choose to create a flow trajectory plot to visualise the flow around the structure. For us to export this into the SOLIDWORKS simulation study, we then need to go to the Tools drop-down menu and select Export Results to Simulation. Once this has been completed, we can now simply turn off all the plots that are currently showing. I'm now going to navigate to the Simulation tab and create a brand new study with the name Wind Effects. With the SOLIDWORKS simulation tree, you may notice that the SOLIDWORKS materials have already been transferred from the creation of the part. I'm now going to simply move on to adding in a fixture, which is going to go at the bottom circular face of the traffic signalling pole. To bring in the loads from the flow simulation, we will need to go to the study properties, flow thermal effects, and enable the under fluid pressure option called Include Fluid Pressure Effects from SOLIDWORKS Flow Simulation. We will then need to browse for the results file. And as you can see, you now have the transfer from the flow simulation to the SOLIDWORKS simulation. As the focus is mainly around the traffic light housing body, I will now create a mesh control for those two traffic light bodies. Once I've applied the mesh control, I'm now going to go ahead and simply mesh the rest of the bodies up using a fine mesh density. Once the mesh has been applied, I can now simply run the study and assess my post-processing plots, like my stress plot and displacement plot, for further analysis. My simulation has finished. I'm going to analyse the displacement plot. See the deformations on the model. To visualise the deformations and the flow lag effects with my SOLIDWORKS simulation, I'm now going to right-click on the plot and simply animate. To summarise, we use the SOLIDWORKS flow simulation to simulate the effects of a storm on a traffic light structure. We then exported out the flow results to SOLIDWORKS simulation, where we can further evaluate the response of the structures.